Josh Lindblom back from the bereavement list. He's making the start today.
Yeah, last time out, his last start was back on September 9th.
Lindblom strikes out Perez for out number two.
Yeah, breaking balls galore for Lindblom. He's got an arsenal of different off-speed pitches. He throws six pitches altogether.
Lindblom steps off the rubber. They've got Mondesi in a rundown. Throw to second. Kira applies the tag. And that's how the inning ends. Trying to get Lindblom to balk, and he wouldn't do it.
Brad Keller has not allowed a home run in his 43 and two-thirds innings, and he's only given up two extra base hits.
Yeah, I mean, he's been phenomenal.
Mejia did not make a good throw, and Nicky Lopez either had his foot on the bag or applied the tag, but he goes down hard. It's almost like Mejia lost track of the outs, because if you're going for two there, you'd expect a little firmer throw from the third baseman to the second baseman.
That was not pretty. Didn't have his feet under him at all. Short arm. He just kind of tried to, he didn't throw it. Look, he kind of babied it over there. Man, that's really a vulnerable spot there for a second baseman. You hope Nicky's okay. Now, it looks like his left ankle might have taken the brunt of that shot there, but man, that was dangerous.
Here's the 3-2. Vogel back to center. Way back. Vogel back has gone deep again. Second time in this homestand.
How about Pizza Ranch? It never fails, does it? First home that Keller's given up this year. Got to go back to August 9th of last year, last home run he allowed, and Vogelbach taking him deep. That was a blast. Way back in center.
Instead of pop-up on the infield, that'll work. Into right center. Long run. Peterson able to make the catch. Boy, did he a great jump on that play in right. And Merrifield off the end of the bat. Kira's right there. And it's another zero for Josh Lindblom in the third. Works around that leadoff base hit.
3-2 is swung on and missed at a good slider from Keller. There's his second strikeout on the day as he gets Hira for the first out in inning number four. There's a swing and a miss at a fastball up and a strikeout for Keller. That is his third and a second straight 1-2-3 inning.
There's a good looking swing. Good call, Hutt. Not only does Mejia have his first hit today, but it's going to be an extra base hit. And he'll stop at second base with a leadoff double.
There you go. Got to have a batting average. His teammates are happy for him.
That's a pretty good swing. Mejia able to drive that one into the gap. Leadoff double.
There's
a ground ball to the right side, so it's an out, but it gets Mejia to third. Up the middle, the Brewers will take the out. The Royals will take the run. So the Royals had gone 14 consecutive innings without scoring a run, and Mejia's leadoff double makes it 2-1.
2-1 Brewers looking to add on against Keller, who's gotten better as the game has progressed. Yelich with a shot to right, a base hit for Christian. Good start to the sixth inning for the Brewers offense. To left, a base hit. Squared up that breaking ball.
Man, you can't be hanging breaking pitches to Ryan Braun. I don't care what the count is. He's going to barrel it up.
So the Brewers have two on with nobody out in the sixth.
And that'll bring up Daniel Vogelbach, who has accounted for both Milwaukee runs with a two-run homer in the first inning.
To left center. Deep. He's done it again. Daniel Vogelbach has provided all the offense for the crew this afternoon. What a story.
That's a pretty good pickup, I'd say. My goodness, five RBIs for Vogelbach. This one on a 3-2 pitch. Way back to the opposite field.
Here comes Ryan Braun, playing in the organization for 14 years. Ryan Braun, potentially his last ever game at Miller Park.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, it's a bit of an emotional day. I think it would be a lot different if there were fans here. You know, the whole experience this year feels drastically different than any normal or regular baseball season would, obviously, for so many reasons. But certainly, there's so many incredible moments and memories that I've had an opportunity to be a part of here in this ballpark. So I definitely want to take it in a little bit, just enjoy it, and reflect a little bit today.
Crazy to think he might end it as a DH.
Yeah, why not?
In the National League. 0-1 to him. Chopper, third base side. No play. It's a base hit for Braun.
So the line drive that was right at the center fielder kind of that equals out.
Yeah, they even out, don't they, Rock? It looks like a rocket in the book. That's what he's telling Jason Lane right now, I'm sure.
Salvi blasts it to left field, and that is gone into the second deck. And the Royals keep it interesting in the ninth inning. That's his first hit today. It is his eighth home run. And Craig Counsell gets back on the phone as it becomes a save situation now. It is 5-3 in the ninth.
Josh Hader to try and put the finishing touches on this sweep against Kansas City. Dozier pops it up. Arcia with plenty of room makes the call, makes the catch, and the Brewers finish off the sweep of Kansas City. A 5-3 final. Vogelbach put the exclamation point on this one, driving in five with two home runs, and Ryan Braun, potentially his last game ever at Miller Park, finishes off with a victory.